Perugh, Iron Age Province in Forge of Empires. The second Iron Age province, Perugh, has four sectors. After the previous province already introduced the unit Soldier, Archer, Mounted Warrior and Ballista, this province now adds the last missing unit of the Iron Age, the Legionnaire. All opponent teams have less than 8 units, therefore it is still possible to succeed here with Bronze Age units. Sector 1. The lower right sector has 2 mounted warriors, 1 soldier and 2 legionnaires. Especially for these legionnaires, it is not recommended to try this with spear fighters only. Slingers are important to win this battle as they have a bonus against heavy units like the legionnaire, and due to their range, they do not have to fear retaliation damage. The computer advances slowly. I use the upper corner of the map as a safe spot for my slingers, to protect them from being slaughtered by the mounted warriors. I place my spear fighters like a wall in front of the slingers, on bonus fields of course. In round 2, the mounted warriors attack that isolated spear fighter. I succeed to kill all mounted warriors in that second round, while all other opponent units still are too far away to reach my units. I do not attack the soldier with my slingers, instead I wait and let the opponent get closer. I keep all my units close together so that they can support each other. In round 3, the soldier kills my wounded spear fighter. To avoid retaliation damage, I keep my spear fighters on bonus fields and let the slingers kill that soldier. The opponent's legionnaires are that far away that I still have enough time to do this. In round 4, the legionnaires arrive on my side of the map. I attack one of them from a bonus field. But the bonus is not enough to keep that spear fighter alive. This makes clear why I decided for slingers in this battle. The second spear fighter can attack the legionnaire without fearing the retaliation damage. The slinger then kills that legionnaire using fields the second legionnaire cannot reach. That legionnaire attacks my last spear fighter. I am happy that it survives. I decide not to let it have a suicide attack on the legionnaire, as the slingers will be able to kill it. In the end, I lost 3 spear fighters and won the first sector. Sector 2. In the lower center sector are waiting 2 mounted warriors and 3 archers. Especially the Iron Age archers are strong units and serious opponents for my Bronze Age units. Horsemen or mounted warriors would be best against archers, but I don't want to wait until I have them. Therefore, I use 8 spear fighters. In round 1, the computer keeps its team together, knowing how strong these archers are. I move my spear fighters on bonus fields outside of the archer's range. In round 2, the mounted warriors attack my spear fighters. With their bonus against fast units, my light units dominate in this part of the battle. But afterwards, I have to feel how hard these archers can hurt. only due to my majority I can win quickly, only using 2 spare fighters. Sector 3. In the upper center sector, I again find 2 legionnaires, beside 3 soldiers and 1 archer. As before, I use slingers to fight against legionnaires. The computer moves forward slowly. I use the well-known tactics. I send my spear fighters to bonus fields outside of the archer's range. In the second round, I then have to get closer to the opponent. Otherwise, these archers would hit my spear fighters without having a chance to hit back. It is obvious that the computer has units of a higher age. All hits are heavy. I decide to target the archers with priority. Whenever possible, I offer a spear fighter as a possible target and then let the slingers do their job from behind. In the end, this is successful, but the losses are significant. Fortunately, Bronze Age units are replaced fast. Sector 4. It is absolutely impossible to win the last sector with ballistas, legionnaires and a soldier using spear fighters and slingers only. One possibility would be to wait until I have Iron Age units. As I am impatient, I decide to build a Bronze Age stable and use some horsemen. Together with the slingers, this should be enough. The horsemen will have to destroy the ballistas to avoid that these kill my slingers. I move forward, but still remaining outside of the soldiers' range. I try to keep the slingers out of the ballistas' range. The ballistas fear the horsemen and attack them with priority. This enables my archers to survive. My 4 horsemen can destroy 2 ballistas immediately. The soldier and the legionnaire then kill 1 of my horsemen. Now my slingers have to get closer, with the result that the remaining ballista immediately kills 1 slinger. In round 3, my horsemen can destroy the last ballista. They cannot do much damage against the remaining units, but they already did their job and even a little damage supports the slingers. Unfortunately, my slingers still are far away and cannot make damage immediately. Especially the soldier can walk very fast. To avoid losing all slingers, I send them a bit back until the soldier is killed. Afterwards, the slingers can concentrate on the legionnaires using their bonus and the fact that legionnaires are very slow. Finally, I win this. This fight could be improved a bit, but I think I was able to demonstrate that there is much more than just moving forward with all units and hit. Using the right strategy will be the key to win difficult battles. Owning the province Perugia provides one resource deposit, allowing me to build the related production building after researching it in the tech tree. The scout can be sent out to find the next province.